Daniel Masaoka, do you know what I like?
No. What do you like? Well, I have hints at what you like, but I don't think it's related to what we're going to talk about.
Okay,
today.
Other than that, I like Bulletstorm.
Okay.
I think it was a highly underrated game, but also I like Duke Nukem.
So, I have not heard of Bulletstorm at all. I don't know even...
I'm here to kick ass and chew bubble gum, so and I'm all okay. out of gum.
So it's the Duke Nukem character.
It's
plus his friend.
Duke Nukem plus. Don't worry about that other guy. He's in the real game.
Okay.
But Bulletstorm full clip edition. We're here to play it.
So there was already a Bulletstorm, and this is the full clip version.
Yes.
What makes a full clip versus partial clip?
You know what? I don't know. How much you can shoot out of it.
Okay, well, give me a little context as to what Bulletstorm is, because I don't even know what that is.
Bulletstorm is a first-person shooter by the studio People Can Fly. They did Painkiller, a couple other...
But did not do Duke Nukem.
No, they did not do Duke Nukem. And really, technically, he's not really... in this
so
either.
Really that's not even Duke, that's Nuke Dukem.
No, this is Duke Nukem.
Okay, so they got the licensing at least. Okay.
Yeah. they essentially just retroactively put him in the game. So if I didn't pick Duke Nukem, it would be the normal guy.
Okay.
But now I've got Duke in here because Duke's hilarious.
Okay.
And by hilarious I mean he sucks.
But he has good lines. But he has good lines.
It's gonna be weird, but suck it up. Yeah, yeah, he's got good lines. I would say they made all new dialogue for this.
Wait, are they friends? I'm confused.
Yes, but then they had to put some robot in my brains. He's kind of a little angry at you. Anyway, first person shoot. I'm just going to get past this because who cares? Other than... oh boy! The graphics are great. One second, the mouse is real, real loosey goosey here. Whoop! Nope. There we go. All right. So yeah, this was Unreal Engine. Around the time of like Gears of War and stuff. If you couldn't tell, but yeah, it's pretty. I think it still holds up. It's a first-person shooter, but the real fun of it are the way you kill people. So there's a mechanic called a leash that you get in here, but also you can kick things at people and shoot them to get it explode.
It's a little bit more environmental.
Yeah, so we'll do that again. Or let's have a guy. Where is he? You're getting better. This is kind of pretty early in the game.
Definitely has
Gears
of War movement.
Oh yeah, Gears of War movement. I mean, it's
even visually almost too. You got any idea what we're looking at here? He just likes kicking things, apparently.
Yeah, well, Duke Nukem is known for kicking things.
He doesn't push buttons, he kicks buttons.
Yeah.
Like, if he was in an elevator, he'd be kicking the...
Yeah, actually, later you do go in an elevator. Earlier in the game, I got this leash thing. This is, like, new technology. So, this is how you kind
of... Okay, so we're picking up in
around.
The middle of your game. This is
this is pretty much the beginning.
Okay.
This is pretty much the beginning. Whatever. All right. So I got the leash. It's syncing up with my character, and kind of like you saw with the barrels, we're gonna kind of use this thing to do fun stuff, kind of like this. You leash him into the what is that? Chain link fence.
Yeah.
Yeah. You like that? Yeah. Come get some.
I mean, I think that leash would have gotten caught into the...
Nah, man, it's an electronic leash. You see that? Man, this is just...
An electronic leash.
Yeah, it's the future, man. Mm. It's what you have in the future. You got electronic leashes. This is the very beginning of the game, so they're kind of having me do it a lot. To get used to it. But I've beat this game before. I have not beat this game again yet. I started playing...
This is the same game, but updated? Or is it a whole new...
No, it's the same game, updated visually, and then... but really, the main appeal for me is the inclusion of Duke Nukem.
So the first one, you were not Duke Nukem.
No. This is not a Duke Nukem game. Oh, but look, I wonder why they put these really barbed things here, maybe so I can kick him into it. Like, oh man, I missed. Hold on. Ah, dang it. Wait. There we go. Watch this. Yeah. And then you know you get special. So if you couldn't tell in that screen I was in a little bit ago, you get stuff you can upgrade. But also there's like a checklist of things that like, oh hey, you know, you did something a certain way, you know, like I got a headshot there, obviously pretty easy.
There's like little bonus point things you can get.
Like, okay, you know, I get a couple points for kicking him into a prickly thing, and I'm not doing very good because I'm trying to show off what I'm doing here. When you do get later in the game, the fun part is that you can just wreak havoc so many different ways. It just makes it so fun. But yeah, this game is all about like
so it's kind of like
balls to the wall.
What is that other game where you get creative in killing people, sort of?
BioShock, you know, kind of had a lot of that.
I'm thinking of. It's like you can like tie cables to them and then pull people apart.
Oh, I think you're talking about Just Cause.
Yeah, Just Cause.
Yeah, yeah. But that, you know, that was a third person open world. You know, this is a very linear first person shooter.
You're gonna die.
I know, I'm not doing very good. I need to use my environment.
Pricked.
I like how it slows down a little bit. Yep, there you go. Skill shot. So, you know, like I said, there's a real long list of things that you can like...
But you don't know what they are. Oh, I guess some of them...
If, you know, it's like, okay, pricked, you know, kill an enemy by putting them into a cactus, you know. But then the rest of them, that you don't know until they unlock, and then they have different point values on... based off of impressive.
What are the points used for?
So this, you know, that little drop. See, there's one right there. You go in there and then you spend points
to upgrade. Okay,
to upgrade stuff.
So it's not just to like get like these little, you know, point things for your like profile. It's like there's actual game. Play value towards getting all these points.
Like, you want to be stylistic in the way that you kill people, because I mean you're getting points by doing just normal stuff,
so you want to have obviously. you want to do as many different ways as possible, kind of.
Environmental.
Okay, I want to shoot though.
There we go. Boom, look at all that, a lot of points. All right,
man,
so I'm gonna go over here, get my leash in, so then as you can tell, you know, the available points I can put into my leash here, you know, I can upgrade my capacity, all that fun stuff, buy more ammo, but then you can get charges to do other stuff, and you know, there's a whole list of unlockables. I actually don't remember a ton of them off the top of my head right now.
So when did the original come out, and what were the graphics like?
I don't feel like this is too far off, honestly. I mean, especially on the PC, you know, like it's definitely able to hold up. It's, you know,
same engine.
You know, yeah. I would be surprised if this was not Unreal. I'm gonna go ahead and say it's probably the same engine.
I guess there's multiple Unreal versions, right?
They upgrade. When did it come out? That is a great question. I'd say probably a couple years after. Probably a couple years after Gears of War, right?
The first one.
Yeah. So I'm gonna, if I had to put some money on it, which I don't have any money to put on it, I'd say 2009.
Okay. Yeah, for the PC and the Xbox.
Yeah, it came out for everything. It was not a commercial success. Well, maybe it was. I
didn't hear about it.
Yeah, it did not blow up the charts. But man, I loved playing it. I love every minute of it, because once again, it kind of harkens back to that old Duke Nukem, you know, and then with the 2016 Doom that just came out, you know, you get that taste of like, man, just pure straight dumb action in a way that can't be done. In some other games, you know, it's like you don't want to take yourself serious. If we were actually listening to the dialogue too, we would realize like how dumb and not serious this game takes itself.
It's like Shadow Warrior.
You know, I never played Shadow Warrior, but I thought that was kind of a semi-serious game. No,
I don't. Originally, it didn't take itself seriously.
Yeah.
So I'm pretty early. Like I said, I don't have a lot of the guns and weapons unlocked. I played it a little bit last night, and then I was like, oh man, I gotta play this Duke Nukem stuff. So this really is the first time I'm playing as Duke Nukem. And it looks like
a boss level.
Not yet. I'm just trying to. I mean, it really does look like it's just the same game, but with Duke narrating it. I wonder if even the story sequences, because you know you're like this like drunk space pirate kind of guy.
Can you go see where they all ran out from? I want to see what's behind there. Like to the left, right there.
Here?
Yeah.
Oh, they were just hanging out.
They were just hiding right there. And they're we're just gonna come right out of there.
They were doing a little kissy face.
Should put a door there.
A little kissy face, you know.
Oh. Come on.
So you think I'm gonna kick it?
Nah, you can use your hand.
Yeah.
He should have kicked it.
I don't have time to play with myself.
He should have kicked it.
He should have kicked it, right? So this is, I wish I could get deeper, to show you some of the other weapons in it, but man, like I said, when you get going, like it just, oh man, the adrenaline and the pace of play, just really, really gets you going.
So this is a remake of the first one.
Yes.
And the first one had that, I'm assuming had that, like, that rope. Electric leash.
I mean,
but so you're the cyborg guy in the first one. No, who are you?
No. This guy is always with you, but I kind of skip past it real quick at the beginning. But you can kind of pick between. Hey, do you want to play as Duke Nukem or do you want to play as a normal character?
In the first one, you can pick two.
No.
So, what's the personality like of this first one?
He's kind of. He's kind of like a drunk space pirate.
So similar dialogue.
Well, see, that's why I say that this is genius to put Duke in here, because like this pretty much it was a Duke Nukem game without having the name. So as far as I can tell, and maybe I'm wrong, I actually don't know if there's anything that different about this version, other than, you know, some updated graphics. I'd have to go back and maybe play the original one just to see how it was, but, it's always nicer looking in your head, right, when you go back to it. So this is how I remember it being back in the day, but maybe it wasn't this pretty. So far as I can tell, it's just, updated graphics and the inclusion of Duke Nukem, as the main character, which, you know what, that is enough for me, because like I said, I love this game and I love Duke Nukem. So, you know, what else could I need?
Duke is your alter ego.
Yeah. That's exactly what I think about this game. This game. No means to give chase. I like the way your new brain thinks. Man, they must have had him in the recording studio a while.
Do you think it's actually the same guy?
Yeah, his name's John St. John.
They didn't bring like a sound alike guy.
He needs work, so you know,
he's probably not expensive.
I think he's a radio DJ.
We should find out
trade.
How much he costs.
Yeah.
Maybe. We can have him voice something for us.
Man, I would love to meet John St. John.
Hardcore hardware. Hardcore. Well, Timmy.
Oh, man. If we could get Gordon, if we get John St. John to play Duke Nukem on Hardcore Hardware, yeah, that'd be great. It wouldn't happen. I'm sure he four Duke Nukem appearances. Well, no, it's trademarked. You can't do that.
But that's just his voice, right?
Nah, it's a character. I'm sure the character is trademarked.
Yeah, no, but I mean, like, him talking probably just sounds like this.
It actually is not. It does not. I've definitely heard him speak normally.
Are you sure?
It's not as cool.
We should do the rest of the show like this.
Yeah.
Daniel Masaoka. I don't got time to play with myself.
I'm getting my butt kicked.
You broke character.
I'm getting my butt kicked.
Alrighty. Oh.
Oh, crap. Is there somebody in there?
Yeah. So I'm trying to leash him out of it.
You leashed him.
Boom.
It's still shooting you. It's still shooting you. Can't run. You should have hopped into it.
I don't think I can.
I don't got time to hop in a helicopter.
Yeah, this is a lot of lines.
I mean, yeah, it's...
They should have just built, like, a Siri so they could just, like, type in all the words that they need.
I know, right?
Just make all the sounds.
You know, yeah, this game, there's not a lot of, like, customization. I'll go into the options here. You know, you've got the resolution, the post-processing quality texture, and then the...
So pretty basic. FPS.
Pretty basic, especially for a PC game, but, you know, I think because... I mean, maybe... Maybe we're getting up in like 10 years.
How much is this game?
Oh, I don't remember. I think it's like $40.
Jesus.
But man, it is a one hell of a shooter, and I gotta say, it still holds up, dude. It still holds up.
I don't know if I'm convinced.
I would play this over the next Call of Duty, if I had to pick. Whoops. I watched this. Oh, here's one.
Kick him off the ledge.
Yeah. Vertigo.
Oh,
groovy.
That's what Vertigo is. You get points every time for Vertigo?
Yeah.
Okay, but
so
less
points, you know, depending on the first one. But, you know, if you can combo it, that's the fun part. Oh. I got ripped off there. That wasn't... but also, if you start doing a lot of the same stuff over and over again... I think they kind of penalize you.
There was a guy who was right there.
No, that was my guy. Oh, I'm hitting the wrong button. Whoops! Haha.
I thought it was like
that's my guy.
That's your guy.
Hey,
is he Asian? I can't tell.
He is Asian. Yes.
What's his name? It's good to see your sense of
humor coming back. I can't remember.
Well, you're killing me, pal.
What would you say? How long is gameplay for this one?
Probably a good solid 10 hours if I had to guess.
So that's a relatively quick game then.
I mean, it's. But man, it's one of those games that just gets you going. When you're in the middle of it and you're feeling the combos, you got all the weapons to you. Man. Gag reflex? Oh, got him in the neck. Oh, missed. Come on. Oh, he's too far, maybe. There we go. That's what they wanted. Flak.
Oh, hell yeah. This is good stuff here.
That's good stuff.
Oh, hell yeah. This is good stuff here. More of Serrano's mindless
tools. Your rage is misdirected. So, in the... Oh,
why
yeah.
Why is that guy so serious?
Because he's half cyborg. I mean, if you were half cyborg, wouldn't you also not want to be serious?
So he's like the Borg?
Yes, he is exactly
Borg,
like the Borg.
We're serious people.
Turret gunner up topside. Grab cover.
There we go. Nice.
Oh, you're locked in now.
So that was like an overshot kind of thing.
Kick that guy. That guy wants to be kicked.
Boom. Whoops.
Just keep kicking it.
Who wants some? They got more.
Yeah. This is definitely a Duke Nukem kind of game.
Taste my thunder.
I mean, I wish they had some pig cops, though.
I know, right? Down you go.
Like, there should be a pig cop in that helicopter.
How do you know, right? If there's not? I'm blowing it up before you can even see. The story, the main story is all used up.
That was a pretty easy area assault.
Yeah, right. Come on, where's my guy? There's a boss up ahead.
He's right. He was right there.
There he
kicks it. You should have just.
I know, right? I like doing the slide attacks too. I forgot that's one of them.
Slowing down. I kind of want to see from a distance him doing this slide.
Oh, like if you could switch to third person?
Yeah, because like this slide is...
Ah!
Slide kick. He's not going to go over the edge.
Damn it. Damn it.
All right, I'll slide kick this guy. Yeah, Not super impressive, but you know, it gets the job done.
It's like a soccer slide.
Yeah. There you go. Man, I keep hitting the wrong button. So, yeah, they start to really throw some baddies at you. Anyway, Bulletstorm, you're not convinced? But you're not much of a shooter
guy,
huh?
I'm not much of a first-person shooter, especially these are like, you know, where you just keep running and shooting.
No, this is not just keep running and shooting, man.
Okay, grabbing and kicking and shooting.
Yeah, and then later a lot of other things, too. Oh.
It feels like it could get repetitive. Oh, but I guess for 10 hours, it's a quick game.
Whoa. It's a quick game, and in terms of first-person shooter, I tell you what, this has a lot of replayability.
Well, is there multiplayer?
There is multiplayer, but I don't know if it's any good. Also, maybe that's something they added to the new version, because I don't remember multiplayer in the old version. That's it.
Dinner time.
I'll need a moment. Oh. Oh, the guy, he needs to recharge.
Is he, like, putting his penis to it? Can I say that?
No. We're not allowed to say that. Oh.
Talk to me! You scared the
Well, if he could say it, then if he could say that, I can say penis.
Daniel, you scared the off of me.
I don't think you can say that.
Ah, oh, damn it.
It is a penis.
Let's climb.
I guess we'll tag this as mature.
Yeah.
For the violence.
Yay! Quick time. Yeah. Unfortunately, this does have QTEs. Cargo train up ahead. Last train out of Explosion Town. Move your shit. Oh, this game. I tell you what.
You're going to tell me what?
It's real dumb. If you couldn't tell already, Daniel, it's real dumb.
I think I can tell. Dumb does not mean bad, though.
I had a huge old good time with it back in the day.
It's like watching The Hangover.
Yeah, a real good dumb old time. It's the Hangover
it's
of
fun,
video
but
games.
But sometimes it's fun.
Nice. See, I thought maybe you'd be into the, the aspect of trying to get the highest score and everything. Oh, uh-oh. Let's see if I can get this boss, huh?
Kick him.
He says a lot.
I think you should have kicked him. Slide, tackle him, and kick.
I don't think, he doesn't want to go anywhere. That was probably not the best approach. Anyway, Dan, thanks for sitting down and playing some Bulletstorm with me. I think it's a highly underrated game. I think you should buy it just for the sheer fact that I love it.
You love a lot of things, though.
It's true. But Bulletstorm is definitely one of those things that needs a lot more love from a lot more people. So go out and get it. I promise.
You promise.
That you
don't make any guarantees.
I promise that you will own it if you go out and buy it.
Okay.
I guarantee it. Anyway. Thanks, Dan.
All right.
Bye.